Hope so the PPT is visible. Let me give you a quick recap. Parsing and error recovery, this is what we discussed. When it comes parsing and error recovery, there are two things. One is, the moment it finds an error, first mechanism, whether it is a recovery or not a recovery technique, but it has to detect an error. The moment it detects an error, either it can stop immediately and report to the error, or it can record the error information and it can continue with the compilation. C is this kind of thing. Record the error, then it continues. When it becomes Java, it immediately stops, it signals an error, then only you can proceed. So it depends upon the language designer. Either it can stop immediately and signal error, or it can record and proceed further. So this is what we discussed in the previous class upon this. Error recovery, how it happens? After detection, definitely it's supposed to go for error recovery if it is required. So it ultimately adjusting the input stream. What is input stream? The input given to the compiler. What is again input? The input is always the user written programs or projects, anything it could be. So user developed program is treated as an input stream to the compiler. Then it parses and continue with deletion of tokens or insertion of tokens, substitution of tokens. Finally, what is the meaning of token? It's a combination of a string construct that has a specific meaning in the language compilation or language execution or programming execution. So there are three possibilities only available. Either it can delete the token, or it can insert the token, or it can update the token. So these are all the three methods available. Then recovery mechanism, at the outset, they are telling two different methods. One is local recovery, another one is global recovery. What is local recovery is, during the compilation, the moment it detects an error, then that is termed as local recovery. What is global recovery? Before even compilation, it starts doing the analysis. Almost we can say it's a pre-compilation. So unless otherwise the compiler or that grammar intelligence is provided, any of the logic cannot detect the error. So definitely it has set of rules and regulations, or rules and grammars. Using that rules and grammars only, it starts parsing. So global error recovery is a bit costlier affair with respect to time and with respect to space. So that global error recovery, mostly it will be in terms of theoretical discussion. Least cost global error recovery is available, one method. So that is what practically viable, that is what practically existing. So that we are going to touch upon today. So I'll be illustrating how the local recovery is happening, how the global recovery as well happening. So these things are, today it's going to become a topic of discussion. So today the topic of discussion is how the local, what is happening? Somebody opened. Okay, in general, the type of errors are compile time error, runtime error. So when it comes compile time error, lexical phase error, syntactic phase error, semantic phase error, already I illustrated in the previous session what is lexical, syntactic and semantic phase, just to take a lead. Whenever in terms of lexical error is detected, merely it works based on regular grammar or regular expressions. The moment you write in terms of rules or productions, writing in terms of expression like union, concatenation, closure, positive cleanse closure and star cleanse closure, these all termed as regular expression. So how it does is, using this kind of representation or grammar itself, any of the construct takes this form, is treated as token. Any of the construct treated this form or takes this form, resembles this form, it's treated as letters token. Anything else, it is treated as an error. So this is how the rules are written in order to detect lexical error. When it comes parser error, all the empty spaces, whenever if we leave it as empty space, what would happen is that would lead to non-determinism. Machine cannot read emptiness. Machine cannot take decision on emptiness. So in order to avoid that, instead of emptiness, while problem solving, we all can use just empty cells, because no action is possibly suitable for that particular entry. Neither it is possible to put a shift action, nor it is possible to give accept action, nor it is possible to give reduce action. So all the possible actions related to shift reduce parser or LL parser are there. You will have grammar. If there is no grammar for that combination row and the column, it is treated as empty. Whenever emptiness is available, machine will get into infinite loop or it may crash as well. So we may need to determine that. So all the empty cells are treated with error notification according to the context that error report need to be done by the compiler designer. What is the error report writing? Just a printf statement. If that combination comes, what is the message to be conveyed, display message to be conveyed to the user, need to be taken care by the compiler developer. The respective row and the column. So every time it seems to be empty, that emptiness need to be filled by an error report. There is no error report like documents together and all. It's a kind of print notification. So through print needs to give some message to the user. So what is error recovery? Upon this error combination, we can work for further recovery mechanism. Next, semantic error. What is semantic error? Never it will be notified to the user. Upon the output, a user need to go for tracing the construct of the program. If you look at syntactically, this seems to be correct. A is equal to B. The value of B is assigned to A. But here A is declared as an array. B is an integer normal variable. So name of the array alone indicates base address of an array. But we are trying to give value to the address operand. So value which is available in B is assigned to the address variable A. That becomes erratic construct. This itself treated as semantic error only. It will be given to the user notification. So next one is, it will not notify to the user. If k is equal to 1, return 1, print of k. In this scenario, no error notification. Rather, it sees, the moment it sees return statement, the main function will be terminated. The subsequent instructions will not be considered at all. So this is termed as semantic error. Altogether, we have come across the four types of error recovery mechanism: panic mode error recovery, phrase level recovery, error production, and global correction. What is the error production is, we may need to write exclusive productions to collect or harvest all the erratic situations or tokens. It should harvest all the erratic tokens. That is the main role of that production. So what is panic mode error recovery? So what it does is, it starts skipping, discards means skipping, all the symbols until the synchronized tokens found. For example, it starts reading this sentence. Let us take for example. So this is the token, perhaps maybe right, usually maybe the right. Until it founds the appropriate token, it starts discarding all other tokens. This is what called panic mode error recovery. So it is possible to correct only the single error, but because of that correction to additional error. So that is the drawbacks of this particular method, panic mode error recovery method. So what is the meaning? Synchronized token may be semicolon. Until that, if it finds something wrong, it starts discarding. It will keep discarding that all the characters. Then it goes for synchronized token identification. Until then, it will be just skipped. But those errors will be notified in the syntactic constructor, definitely. So this is simplicity. seems to be simple, but it may get into an infinite loop. Next, phrase level recovery. What is this phrase? Look at this word phrase itself. This is itself phrase, example for phrase. Level is one of the phrase. So recovery is one of the phrase. So what will happen? It will start replacing by the appropriate phrase. For example, comma may be replaced by semicolon. Semicolon may be replaced by comma. Delete or insert semicolon. It will try the possibility of repairing the error using an error repairing compiler. So difficulty in accessing the actual error. The moment it finds the error, it starts applying this phrase level recovery. What is exact error? It is tough to find out even by the user. The moment it starts replacing, then it will proceed further. What level that the compiler started making and correction, that will not be possible to notify to the user. Then further complications or the subsequent error definitely may not be captured either by the compiler or by the user or programmer. That may lead to infinite loop as well. So this is a drawback we have seen. These are all discussed in the earlier class itself. As a recap, I'm doing. Next, error production. So exclusive productions are given in the CFG rules itself. Anticipating, expecting what are all the possible errors can happen in the programming or can be induced by the programmer, or what are all the way programmer tend to write wrong way of coding. By consuming or assuming those all those scenarios, if we may need to come out, or the designer may need to, compiler constructor may need to come out with an appropriate grammar rules. So what they will be doing? Using that grammar rule, it is possible to capture the error. Through that, it is possible to diagnose as well. So this is how the systematic way we can move in approaching detecting the error and recovery. So this is one of the best practice. So far now, whatever we have discussed compared to that, this is one of the best practice. Since it is a very appropriate method of capturing error, it is already available in Yawk compiler tool. Yawk is expanded as yet another compiler. As I mentioned in the previous session, this is one of the popular tool for syntactic analyzer. So you can make it as a plugin in your new compiler development itself. Plenty of tools available exclusively for each and every phase. For the lexical analyzer, Lex is a tool available. For the syntactic analyzer, Yawk is a tool available. Similarly, for subsequent other phases also, exclusive list of tools available. Whenever you are aiming to write a new programming construct or programming language, you can make use of the existing tools if it is suitable for your programming paradigm. So you may develop object-oriented programming language, you may develop structured programming language, or you may develop interpreter. So what is the way you are functional programming language? So what type of language you are intended to develop, that decides whether that tool is suitable for your compiler design or not. So this kind of error recovery mechanism or detecting mechanism is incorporated into the famous compiler construction tool called Yawk. This is useful for syntactic analyzer. Next, we are touching upon a new topic, that is global correction. What is the global correction is? Compilers that make possibly few changes to the process of incorrect input string before even submitting to the actual compilation, it will start detecting the incorrect input string and it starts correcting it. So that is called global correction. If you look at incorrect input string is using the grammar G, the algorithm construct the parse tree with a small number of transformation. So it won't do all the possible combinations. If it starts doing possible combination, time complexity, space complexity will be more. Whenever combinations, permutations are involved in our logical construct, definitely that would lead to larger amount of time complexity, larger amount of space complexity. So that is the reason it's a costlier strategy. It's only for theoretical discussion. Practical, this will lead to, practically this will lead to high amount of complexity with respect to both space and time. So it is considered only for the theoretical interest. However, a part of global correction mechanism has been implemented. How that is implemented, let us visit shortly. Look at, we are considering bottom up error recovery, bottom up parser, local error recovery mechanism. Capture the word. This is local error recovery. What is the meaning of local error recovery? During the compilation, the recovery process will happen. Global error recovery will happen before the compilation. See the underlying point. This is what difference. Internal mechanism, let it be. Local error recovery mechanism will be carried out during the compilation process. Global error recovery mechanism, early stage of the compilation process. That you should capture. Next, look at this grammar. Expression produces number. The expression can have a number, no? A plus 2 also can be written. A into B also can be written. That is why expression produces number. Next, other production, expression plus expression. This L parenthesis, this is called left parenthesis. This is called right parenthesis. It can be parenthesized expression as well. These are all the way people tend to write grammar. You can't expect the same conventional way what we have seen with the grammar. Next, what is this expression? This expression can become recursively, because you may write a lengthier expression. A plus B into C divided by D the whole square. You may write like that. So this individual expression can become expression or set of expression, semicolon expression. Semicolon followed by expression also can be continued. So this is again expansion of the non-terminal called expression, in which are all terminal. Number is terminal, plus is terminal, left parenthesis is terminal, right parenthesis is terminal. So rest all are non-terminal. So what they would be doing? This is the general strategy in both of the parser, bottom-up parser, top-down parser. This is a general strategy. Look for a synchronizing token. Until then, you skip and go ahead. That is what they mean to say here. Until how that skipping is possible. Theoretically, we are talking, yes, skip until you see the right token. How internally you can dictate the machine. So if I'm asking a human to solve the problem during the examination or assignment, you all can solve easier. But how you are enabling the machine to do like a human is a question here. So we may need to feed a logic. So solving a paper problem on a paper is different. Making machine to deduct and correct is different scenario. So that we may need to write a grammar method. How this grammar can happen is expression with parenthesis in between may happen to be error. Here, within this also the expression can become error. Or expression for produces expression. Here, this grammar we are rewriting. Error is one of the terminology we are including, or this can be treated as a terminal. Error can be a terminal. So what that error? So anything that pattern doesn't matches with the original grammar. The top two boxes are original grammar. Anything doesn't matches with those two top boxes, immediately it will be treated as an the third production error grammar. So what it does is, between the left error, you would have been seen error is the word before the error, after the error, in between whatever is not suitable with the first two boxes, those all will be treated as an error. So the moment it will harvest all the error, I will show you one example, you may able to understand. That need to be deleted or discarded. This is how the logic works. The logic behind of error detection and recovery is purely based on the grammar. that grammar is introduced with the error tokens or error grammars, error productions. Grammar or productions in order to harvest the error. Suppose expressions produces expression, this expressions rewritten by error here. So none of these two productions doesn't suit, either it will validate with this production or it will validate with this production. Somehow it will try to capture an error. The moment it captures an error and it constructs or it labels it as error, that will be discarded. So this is the intuitive understanding you need to have for local error recovery. Look at here, local bottom-up error recovery, how it does is the same. The previous slide, this slide, there is no big difference. Only the change is how that error is collected, harvested, and how the synchronizing token is identified. There are four methods. Either you can continuously pop the stack until an appropriate state is reached, or shift the error token, shifting to the stack. Discard the input symbol, or just you can discard the input symbol. These are all the things you can repeatedly continue with error recovery mechanism. Finally, resume the normal parsing. Once you find synchronized token, resuming is possible only when synchronized token is identified. Otherwise, these three only will be repeating: popping the stack content, shifting the error token, discarding the input symbol. So these are all the three methods will happen. Yeah.
I'm sorry, ma'am. Yeah. The slides are not changing, ma'am. It is showing first slide itself, type of
really? Error.
Really? Yes, ma'am.
You would have informed no earlier. I was kept on talking. Why? What you were doing earlier?
I thought it's just going on that stuff only, ma'am. But I didn't think they're showing other slides.
This slide, have you seen, ma'am? This slide. Global correction and all?
No, ma'am. No slide. It is showing from type of errors only.
Listen, 1 minute. This is the first slide. Next, have you seen?
No, ma'am, it's not changing only.
Now also?
Yes, ma'am.
Why so it is? 1 minute. Now is it changing?
Yes, ma'am, yeah.
Okay, exactly. Error recovery. This is what we discussed. This all, the earlier session only I was continuing. Type yes, of errors. These all I was giving a quick review. You can mute, ma'am. These all the previous session discussion only we did. Yes. What is happening? Lot of noise comes out. So this all we discussed in the previous session. Now this is the slide. You please focus here. This you should understand. Only then you can continue with what I am telling in the next slide. So these are all the original two grammar. In order to capture the error, for the error recovery or detection itself, this is required. So we are introducing error term. What is error term is, whichever the construct or the tokens are wrongly written by the programmer or input is wrong, then that all captured using this error production. Either this is the pattern error may happen or this is the pattern error may happen. So either one of the pattern, it will choose and it will capture the error. The moment it captures the error, that error can be discarded. So that is the message I conveyed. Now come here, how that error is captured is, either stack content can be popped or token may be shifted to the stack. Shifting is pushing operation. Popping is taking out and reduce operation. Discard the input symbol, or else you can just discard the input symbol. All the three combinations also you can try it. Pop stack, shift the error token, discard the input symbol. All the three also you can continue. When you can resume the normal parsing is, the moment you find out synchronizing token, you can resume the normal parsing. This is how local bottom-up recovery parsing is functioning. Next is, look at this. Now only I am just, these are all a general construct, these two slides. Now at least pay your attention, you can understand what I said in the previous few minutes, though the slides are not visible. Now is it visible, ma'am? See, look at here, at hash dollar is available. This slide yet to read. this word you should see. Yet to read. Could you see yet to read on the slide? Anyone can unmute and answer to me.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Now look at, this is the original grammar. This is also an original grammar. This is what error deduction mechanism. A production for error deduction or these two. These. Now look at input given by the user is number plus open bracket number plus number. It should become plus number, but how they are writing, look at here. These are all the input construct, which is wrong. If you look at, this is what unexpected expression. By mistake, while you are writing an expression, you would have clicked this symbol. At symbol, hash symbol or dollar symbol, or purposely or unconsciously, let it be. So these two are the symbol finally the parser or during the compilation process need to capture. This capturing need to be identified as an error. That need to be discarded. The rest of the process need to be resumed. How the final appropriate expression, look at number plus open bracket number plus. This plus is also not appropriate, no? Plus maybe unary expression if you consider, then one plus need to be given. Number close bracket plus number. Somewhere here the mistake is available. How it starts doing is, until finding an appropriate construct or expression, it will be treated as discarded symbol. This is what unexpected expression. At hash and dollar is unexpected expression. So how it does, let us see. Pop stack until shifting the error can consult the correct parse. This is a shifting error. It will start shifting, or it can go for discarding the input. Either finally, that entire construct, it will be treated as an error. Finally, it comes with expression plus expression. Now it has come to an appropriate construct. Now the continuation of parsing happens. Look at, once again, I will play this. This is the original grammar, the top two boxes. Then this original grammar not at all capable of capturing the error production. It can verify, but it cannot capture an error production. In order to capture an error production, newly these productions are introduced. The role of these productions are only to capture an error. So now we are keeping all the three sets of grammars together. These two are original grammar. This is for error capturing grammar. It is dictated to do anything. Freedom is given. Given the freedom, you are ready to do. Imagine bottom up parser. What is that bottom up parser? All the LR parsers are example for bottom up parser. What you would be doing? You will have a table, row and column wise table you will have. You will go for lookup. Every moment, every action, you will be looking into row and column. Either it will dictate you shift action, or it will dictate you pop or reduce action. Reduce means pop action. Now there is one more new action is given here, that is discard input, then resume the normal parsing. This is how it works. So local bottom up parser, assuming that, look at the way user has written number can be reduced as expression. See, it is working well. Then plus, yes, there is one more production available with plus, but next, looking at number, it starts reducing it as expression. Then looking at the plus, it retains the plus. Finally, it should become expression. It is not happening. Why it is not happening? At hash dollar. Look at the given grammar, three boxes. None of the grammar has these combinations. So we may need to handle the situation, or not we, the compiler may need to handle the situation. So how we can direct is the discussion now. So look at now, finally, the right and this stack content should be of this pattern or this pattern or this pattern. So how it works, let us see. So pop until stack shifting error. So first we need to shift this symbol. This all the symbol we need to either discard or pop the symbol. All the stack content you pop. So next, shift error. Finally, we are reducing those all content into error. Other than that, any combination comes. These are all the defined protections. Other than this pattern, anything has been seen, it will be treated as error. That is how we may need to write the parser. Or you can go for Discord input until we can legally permitted to do either shift action or reduce action. Finally, this is becoming error, so that will be discarded. Then we are reducing this into expression. Now, entire this parenthesized input is treated as useless. Never you can do anything. See, number plus, you can go for number. Or number plus, you need to eliminate this alone. None of the combination works well. So that finally, after reducing, what we are doing, we are retaining this num replaced by exp plus, then we are retaining the last num. This is how we need to retain and we need to replace it by expression. Somehow the compiler need to continue the parsing action. So this is how local, some intuitive principle only I'm bringing it in. Exactly, it won't happen. So we may need to make you to understand how the error recovery mechanism can happen through the introduction of new error productions only possible. That is the first notion you need to understand. Next, we are randomly taking some wrong input fed by the user. So how that tries to continue? This is what we are attempting. For if you are not able to capture through this example, this is a final technical matter. You are given compiler given the freedom to pop the stack content if necessary, or shift the error token, or discard the input symbol. All the three combinations are expected to be carried out by the error recovery mechanism strategies. Finally, the moment it finds synchronized token, that means appropriate token, it can resume the normal parsing action. This is how you need to understand. This is how you need to write for your examination also. For this technical construct, understanding point of view, I am trying to attempt through one of the example. That's it. Next, coming to global error recovery mechanism. With that, today's session I will be concluding. What is global error recovery? Determines the smallest set of insertions, deletions or replacement that will allow the correct parser. See, already I said, you are given the freedom to update the tokens given by the user, or insertion you can do, or deletions you can do. Out of these three operations, you need to come out with smallest set, smallest possible action you need to take. So how it is doing? Through one example I will make you to understand. Look at MLyawk. This is one of the tool much more advanced than Yawk tool, MLlog. Uses Bergfisher error repairing technique. Bergfisher error repairing technique, what it does is every possible single token insertion, deletion, what method it uses. Look at it, is fixing the fold value, k is equal to 20. If it gets stuck at 500, token number 500, between 480 to 500, it can try for all the combinations. We need to find out the window. That window decides number of tokens need to be considered. Then among that combinations, it will try. Why that window is considered? Look at, it may find error at the position number 3. But not only that error position number 3, we need to take action. We need to consider the best possible combination. For example, A is equal to B plus C, you are trying to write. Simple assignment statement, A is equal to B plus C. You are trying to do A is equal to hash plus B. Somehow you have written that message, that statement wrongly. Or typographical mistake, or you unknowingly you have done that. So that a hash alone, if you try to attempt that time, if you try to discard hash, what will happen? Plus B, nowhere available again. Plus plus B is available. That is pre-increment operator. Simply one plus operator and B, again it will not match at all. There is no use of doing that hash discarding operation. What the global correction says is you need to form the window. The moment you find the error, you need to form the window. The subsequent actions also, subsequent tokens also you need to consider. Based on the subsequent tokens, you need to take decision in correcting. That is what they are trying to tell. Hope so you would be understanding. A is equal to hash plus B. Or hash plus C, you are writing. Instead of B plus C, you are writing hash plus C. What will happen? In the local error recovery mechanism, you are permitted to go for simple insertion, deletion, and updation. So if you try to replace, discard, or delete that hash, then proceed further action. What will happen? No more compilation is possible. Only you have plus C. It is not possible to compile at all. So how that deletion, insertion, or updation need to be considered is you need to form the window. The moment you find an error, you need to form your window. Within that window, all the possible combinations you need to try at. That is what they mean to say. Now that is Burke-Fisher error repairing technique. Look at here, K token window, N different token types. You need to fix number of token types within the window. What is the size of the window? So within that, you need to go for all the possible deletions, insertions, and replacement. This is a time complexity they are telling. If you consider window and different tokens, I will show you what is N and K in the subsequent slide. Look at here. ID equal to num, ID equal to ID plus this. No wrong token, but every time it forms K token. See, look at within this how many token? Semicolon is one of the token. ID is another token. This is Pascal language. When we used to learn Pascal, we need to give colon before the equivalent. So let us consider this is one of the token. This is one of the token. ID is one token plus one token, open bracket, one token. Now, how many token available? Just a quick count you do in your brain exercise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 tokens are considered as a window. This is called 7 token window. This is what I mean to say here, K token window. Next, N different token types. Look at in which ID and D repeated. What are all N repetition? You need to treat it as only one token. How many different tokens are available? Semicolon 1, ID 1, colon 1, equal to 1, plus 1, open bracket 1. 6 unique token, but total tokens are 7. That's all. So this is how you need to interpret this. No need to go further. Just a glimpse sufficient. Next, input string, new stack, old stack. So this is how it functions. So every time it forms K token window having N different tokens, it starts doing these are all the operations, either deletions, insertions, and replacement. These are all the three method it starts doing. That's all. So finally, the magic how to construct an LR parse table is you can do with error production. See, look at error, accept, reduce, shift. With the LR parser, it is very easier or possible to implement with these four actions. Error action we need to define, not like the problem which we have discussed. In your theoretical notion, problems are discussed only with error entry. You will be leaving it as empty. But when the moment you become a compiler developer in the practical notion, you should not leave empty. You need to come out with the error productions. It need to capture that appropriate error. If you wish, you can go for error recovery. Further advanced level of compiler is error recovery compiler. If you wish, you can further, you can proceed or not capture it and report the error to the user. But the error need to be considered, both error detection and error recovery mechanism. So these are all the way. When you can discard or how long you can discard until you find the synchronized token. This is how we used to draw a diagram. In that directed flow diagram, we used to draw in the LR parsing table. So until it deducts an appropriate token on the arc needs to be discarded. That is an indication. That's all. So now LR parsing is more powerful than LL parsing given the same look ahead. What is the look ahead? Both of the parser, you would have noticed, follow symbol is considered. The moment you call, consider the follow symbol, that is said to be look ahead. One symbol, we are looking ahead. One of us or couple of us, we can even conduct a research. Look ahead one in your theory you are discussing. How to look ahead two symbols further? How to look ahead four symbols further? The moment you bring, come out with one invention theoretically, if you propose abstract notion or algorithmically, pseudocode, that itself will become a great invention for the compiler revolution. So for now, practically, they have implemented only one look ahead. So that one look ahead is possible because of follow computation. How that look ahead is achieved? Because of follow computation. That's all. It is necessary to compute LR parser table. It is possible. Always it is necessary. Parse table represents a finite automaton that works over the parse stack. MLOC uses LALR. One more information. MLOC. We say that it is advanced compiler construction tool or syntactic analyzer tool. So what is a kind of parsing action internally it does? So that transparently informed that it is using LALR construct. That's all. So with that, I'm concluding today's session.